This beautiful red Shelby GT350 next to me is not a NASCAR, but YouTube thinks that this is a NASCAR, and therefore NASCAR thinks that this car right here is a NASCAR. I have been going to Road America every year for over 25 years, and for over 20 years I have enjoyed posting track videos of me running cars at the track. Now NASCAR is cracking down on anyone posting videos from their own car on that track and claiming it as their own. They think that they deserve all of the money that the creator earns on that video, and they might even be sending you copyright infringement emails on your own track video. NASCAR is not new to having trouble with creators on YouTube. In 2013, they took a lot of flack for taking down a video that a high school student took at one of their races. NASCAR claimed that they own the rights to any video, sounds, or data related to a race regardless of who shot the video. This agreement is actually printed in fine print on the bottom of all NASCAR tickets. In 2013, YouTube did reinstate that video after scrutinizing the copyright claim. They stated their partners do not have the right to take down videos from YouTube unless they contain content which is copyright infringing. In April 14 of this year, I got a copyright infringement email from NASCAR stating that a video that I posted showing video of me driving a Ford GT40 around Road America was infringing on their copyrights. Obviously, I shot all of this video. It was my own content and it had nothing to do with NASCAR, so I disputed the claim and I thought that was the end of it. However, on July 29 of this year, NASCAR has sent me copyright infringement emails claiming that I infringed on four of their videos. NASCAR is claiming that a video I shot a couple years ago from a GoPro inside of this car is infringing on their copyrights. And they are also claiming that a live video that I filmed from the inside of this car with my iPhone actually infringes on three of their videos. NASCAR is claiming that any money made on ads shown on these videos should go to them. And if you were to look at any three of these videos, it would be obvious that this is all content that I shot myself and has nothing to do with NASCAR. One of the strange things about the copyright claims is that I cannot even find the videos on YouTube that they are claiming that I infringed upon. Those videos have probably been made private and are not even visible publicly. I am a small channel, and although I know how to navigate these copyright claims and hopefully get my videos reinstated properly, there may be many of you who have posted videos of you driving your car on track and NASCAR has sent you a dispute and you don't know how to fight it. By default, YouTube sides with NASCAR, and if you don't do anything about it, any ad revenue will go to NASCAR and your video may even be taken down. If you find yourself in the same situation as me with one of your videos and you do not know how to handle this, feel free to send me an email, thisweekwithcars@gmail.com, and I will try to walk you through the process of disputing it. Thanks for watching, and I hope YouTube can resolve these issues so that we can all enjoy posting videos from our own cars on a racetrack and share them with our friends.